It's been nearly 13 years since the Boeing 787 Dreamliner entered commercial service with Japanese carrier All Nippon Airways, or ANA, in October 2011. Today, Boeing offers three variants of the 787 family: the 787-8, 787-9, and the largest 787-10. As of May 2024, Boeing has delivered over 1,100 units across all variants, with about 800 orders still outstanding. Regardless of the variant, Boeing offers its customers two different engine options for the 787. There's the General Electric GEnX-1B or the Rolls-Royce Trent 1000. Customers generally select engines based on many factors, including fleet commonality, type of contract, price, availability, and route-specific performance. In today's video, we compare the two engines in light of their design and performance characteristics. So, the first engine type available for use on the Boeing 787 that we'll examine is the Rolls-Royce Trent 1000. This high-bypass turbofan design first ran in February 2006, more than 5.5 years before entering revenue-earning service on the Dreamliner. It was developed from the Trent 900, which is one of the options for powering the Airbus A380. Rolls-Royce has produced several different variants of the Trent 1000. The least powerful is the Trent 1000E, which produces 62,264 pound-force of thrust on takeoff and 58,866 pound-force continuously. At the other end of the spectrum, a takeoff powered by the Trent 1000R produces 81,028 pound-force of thrust. These engines have a continuous output of 72,691 pound-force. Despite powering the first ever commercial 787 flight, Rolls-Royce has struggled to gain a solid market share against its GE rival. According to Flight Global, just a third of Dreamliner orders have featured the Trent 1000. In recent years, the engine has suffered supply chain and durability issues. However, the COVID-19 pandemic helped ease these problems as planes flew less. This allowed engine changes to occur on inactive 787s for carriers like Virgin Atlantic. Simple Flying reported that an Air Tanzania Boeing 787 remained stuck in Malaysia since November 2023 due to Rolls-Royce Trent 1000 engine issues. While Rolls-Royce's engine maintenance manual requires maintenance at regular intervals, delayed maintenance and lack of spare engines caused the extended grounding of the aircraft. At the time of making this video, the aircraft is expected to return to service in June. So, hopefully, by the time you're watching this, the Dreamliner registered 5 Hotel Tango Charlie Juliet will be back in the air again. Still, to spend over 6 months on the ground due to supply chain issues must be a massive inconvenience for the airline. But let's move on to the other engine option, the GEnx. General Electric is based in the US and has a commanding share in the 787 engine market. Indeed, the company highlights that it powers two-thirds of 787 Dreamliner aircraft in service. With more than 50 million flight hours since its entry into service, the GEnx is the fastest-selling high-thrust engine in GE history. Last year, Canadian flag carrier Air Canada also sided with the American option, signing a deal for GEnx engines for its 787-10 order. Perhaps this was unsurprising, given the carrier already operates over 35 787-8 and 787-9s, all with GEnx engines. The airline expects to take delivery of its brand new 787 variant beginning in 2025. The GEnx power plant was developed following the Boeing 777's GE90 engine series. Indeed, the GEnx has, in a way, formed the basis for the 777X family in the form of GE9X turbofans. But going back to the 787, the least powerful variant of the GEnx is the GEnx-1B54/P2, which produces 57,400 pound-force of thrust on takeoff and 56,300 pound-force continuously. Contrastingly, the GEnx-1B78/P2 has the highest takeoff thrust, 80,400 pound-force. However, we can find the highest continuous output in the form of the GEnx-1B75/P2 with 68,800 pound-force. With capable engine options, airlines must consider carefully which set they want for their Boeing 787 Dreamliner aircraft. Speaking recently to Simple Flying, Rolls-Royce's chief customer officer Ewan McDonald explained that the airline will do a full evaluation of how good the engines are, a technical evaluation and an economic evaluation. They will ask both companies for a proposal and go through a tender process. In the end, they decide which engine they will take and inform the aircraft manufacturer. Of course, just because an airline operates 787s with one engine type, it doesn't completely rule out the possibility of operating Dreamliners with other engines in the future. In fact, one example of this is Japanese carrier ANA. Its 787 fleet largely consists of jets powered by Rolls-Royce Trent 1000 engines. However, data from planespotters.net indicates that some of its 787-9s and 787-10s utilize GE power plants. This took place in 2020 as it announced an order for more Dreamliners. Up until that point, the airline had gone all in on the Trent 1000. However, the airline's newer order sided with GE. It's possible that leadership realized that dependence on one engine type has left it vulnerable to issues that could ground an entire fleet. Admittedly, ANA is one of a few rare cases operating both GE and Rolls-Royce powered 787s, but it's not alone, or won't be alone in the future. Indeed, Air New Zealand, which operates Rolls-powered 787-9s, has an outstanding order for GEnx-powered 787-10s. Most recently, Thai Airways also announced it was mixing things up. The airline, like Air New Zealand, operates Rolls-Royce-powered 787s at the moment. However, its recent deal for 45 787-10s will be powered by GEnx-1B engines. A long-running dispute between the airline and Rolls-Royce over engine and maintenance pricing is reportedly one reason why Thai chose the Boeing aircraft with GE engines over ordering more A350s. Most often, or at least historically, carriers would prefer, or have preferred, to proverbially put all their eggs in one basket and stick with just one engine manufacturer to streamline their operations. Major 787 operators exclusively using Rolls-Royce Trent 1000s include British Airways and Singapore Airlines, while large carriers like Air Canada, American Airlines, Qatar Airways and United Airlines have opted for the GEnx. Not all planes require customers to make such a choice. For example, the Airbus A350 is powered exclusively by Rolls-Royce Trent XWB turbofans. The UK-based engine manufacturer celebrated the delivery of the 1,000th example in 2021. Were you aware of the choice of engines available to Boeing 787 operators? Do you have a favourite manufacturer? Let us know your thoughts by leaving a comment down below. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.